Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a meal prep with me. Sorry, my cats are always so annoying once I start filming. But anyways, today's video is going to be a meal prep with me. I have not meal prepped in probably like 2 years, but I started thinking about it and I was like, meal prepping makes so much sense for me and my life. You ever make just a serving, one serving size of rice in a pot? Like, no, you always make more. Also, recently I've been breaking out so much. I've been like drinking. It was my birthday, my 22nd birthday recently, so I've been celebrating for the past like week and I'm over celebrating now. I just want to be like back on my healthy grind. So that's kind of like, today is Sunday and I'm gonna like focus on, you know, just getting back on my grind and doing things that help me achieve my goals. So that's why we're gonna be meal prepping today. I have breakfast. I think I'm gonna make a couple lunches, but for the most part, I'm gonna be having salads for lunch. And then I also have dinner. So there's gonna be like different variations to everything because I cannot eat the same thing every day. I'm so pale right now. I can't stop looking at myself in the viewfinder being like, wow, like I'm really pale right now. So excuse that. I self-tan on Sundays, so maybe at some point throughout this video, I'll be a little bit tanner than I am right now. Make sure to also subscribe if you aren't already so that way you guys can join in on my fitness journey. And just like, if you want health videos, subscribe because I would really appreciate it. But I guess let's get into making breakfast. So for breakfast, I think I'm gonna do an overnight oats. I've shown this recipe or like similar recipes to this on my channel before, but I'm gonna show it again because it's really easy and it's like the perfect thing to meal prep because it's so easy. All right, so here's everything. I laid it all out that you're gonna need for this one. It's so simple. I have some coconut almond blend milk. This is really, really good, so I highly recommend trying that out. Then I have chocolate chips. These are just some quick oats, and the serving size on these I already checked is half a cup, so we're gonna follow that guideline. And then over here, I'm gonna use my almond butter, but if I run out, I have my pumpkin spice peanut butter just in case if I run out. And then your choice of fresh fruit. So I just washed some blueberries and I have those right there. I have my measuring cup. And then I did 5 glasses. Taking about a half a cup of oats, I'm just gonna add that into each of these mason jars. That way we have the perfect serving in each of them. Okay, so we got all the oats added in, and now I'm gonna do the same amount or maybe even a little bit more, so probably about a little bit more than half a cup. Okay, so I think I have enough almond milk in here to be able to do half a cup in all of these, but if I start to run out, I'm gonna do water in a couple of them and then add a little bit of brown sugar to like equal it out, but I'm gonna hope that I have enough. So somehow, some way, we perfectly had enough almond milk left for all of them. And now I'm gonna do like probably a little bit less than half a cup of water in each of these just to make sure that there's enough liquid to oats ratio. Like I said, I'm gonna do some chocolate chips, and then I have my peanut butter slash almond butter situation and blueberry. So you can do whatever kind of fruit you want, and just, you know, you wanna have a little bit of fruit or peanut butter or chocolate in every bite. So add a good amount in, cause that will make them taste a lot better. It's really not that many blueberries. It's just, you know, a lot for the mason jar. So there we go. Just adding a handful into each of these. You want to mix everything together. I totally forgot, but if you want to, you can always add in other things like little nuts and stuff. Right now, I'm probably gonna add to all of mine some chia seeds. All right, finally, here is the official finished product of all of my overnight oats. I accidentally added quite a few chia seeds into this one, so ignore that, but it's all good. They don't taste like anything. So yeah, here is breakfast all done. I know it doesn't look too appetizing. It's not the most beautiful thing in the world, but this will keep you full for so long. The calories in it are pretty good, and it's just like a good breakfast to have on the go, especially because it's so easy to meal prep. As you guys saw, it probably took me like maybe 15 minutes to do everything, and that was because I was like talking through half of it to a camera. So this is a really quick, easy meal to make, and you can easily customize it to whatever you like. You can add literally anything to these, so give it a try and let me know what you guys think. Okay, I apologize if behind me you can hear the chicken cooking. We have that happening, so there's a lot of sizzling going on, but I wanted to show you guys really quickly what I'm gonna be having for lunch every day. So I am gonna be using these containers that we got for lunch. I'm gonna prep them like every single day just because it's a really good size, and I like having like consistently the same amount of food, you know, so that way my like body is used to it and everything. But I'm just gonna be having, to be honest you guys, a really quick Caesar salad today. But I wanted to show you guys that sometimes I go back and forth between these two dressings from Ken's. So this one is the light creamy Caesar. Just make sure that you go, no pun intended with the word light, but really light on the dressing. It says 2 tablespoons is the serving size, and it's 90 calories for that much. As long as you're not overdoing it with the dressing, it's really okay. But then Zesty Italian is also a great option because this one, oh, this one actually has the same amount of calories as the creamy Caesar. I'm pretty sure I have another, wait one second. I have another one in here, or did I throw it out? Oh my gosh, did I throw it out? Let me see what this one is. This one is 70, so this one's from Newman's Own. I don't know why I have that Zesty Italian one. I think my mom gave me that one, but I got one from Wegmans not too long ago that had like 40 calories per tablespoon. So with like certain dressings, you can definitely get away with using more. I don't really need that much on my salad to begin with though, because I add some hot sauce to it. I know it's so weird you guys, but Fab put me onto it, and honestly it makes using less dressing so much easier because this kind of gives it like a, you know, a liquidy feel to the lettuce. That's the best way I can describe it. So it makes you feel like you have more dressing on than you actually do. So yeah, I'm gonna use these two today, and then for cheese, you don't even need cheese, but I use a really small amount of the Parmesan Romano blend. So I'm just gonna wait for the chicken to finish cooking, cut that up, put it on top, and then add these three things. I was gonna say all of them, but we're not gonna add this one today. Okay, so I just finished putting everything into my salad, and I wanted to show you guys what the best part about these containers is the fact that when you make a salad with them, you just shake it all up like this, and it distributes the dressing and the hot sauce or whatever else you put in your salad so perfectly, and it just coats all the lettuce so well. So that way, let me get it all flattened out. When you open the lid up right here, dun, da, da, da. Come on, why does it take it so long? Look at that. Look at that, you guys. Everything is so evenly coated, and it makes it feel like you used so much more dressing than you actually did. Because now, like, every bite that you take is going to have the taste of the dressing on it. All right, y'all, so here is the finished product of my salad. I know it's not, like, the most revolutionary thing. It's just chicken Caesar salad, but for some reason, I have been craving it nonstop recently, so that's why I'm just feeding into my craving, you know, trying to make it a little bit healthier with less dressing. I feel like it looks like it's from McDonald's or something, for some reason, because of like it being in this takeout container like this, but it just makes my life a lot easier. All right, moving on to dinner here. So Fab and I actually got these awesome little containers. These are from Wegmans, but they're just like black containers that are perfect for meal prepping. I think I'm gonna make 8 little dinners in total, just that way, you know, if I want to have one of these for lunch, I can, or if, you know, I don't know, I'll just make 8 of them to have a little bit extra. So all I need for this, or at least what I'm gonna do, is have some thin sliced chicken breast cutlets. These are really good and they cook super fast, so I love them when they're thin sliced and not like the regular chicken breast that's like super thick. And then over here I have, these are a baby white potatoes. So for my carb for like dinner, I'm gonna switch off half of them doing basmati rice, which is my favorite kind of rice ever, and then half of them with potatoes. So that'll just, you know, switch it up a little bit. And then for my veggies, I have 2 different options. So I love broccoli, so that's like a perfect one for me. And then I saw this in my freezer and I figured I would try it out since, you know, we're coming up on spring here. And this is a spring blend of yellow squash, green beans, red peppers, and onions. And this is supposed to just cook really quickly on the stovetop. So we'll see how that goes. I'm gonna hope that this is good because I like all of those ingredients. So hopefully I'll like it all together. But I think to start this off, the chicken cooks really fast and same with the veggies. So I'm gonna start by doing the potatoes because those will probably take the longest out of everything. Okay, quick little tip I have for you guys. Also, shout out to my mom. She got me these pans from William Sonoma, and they're like the best thing in the entire world because they're so nice. I feel so bougie when I use them. But quick little tip is, if you are trying to save calories, instead of using like full-on olive oil all over them, just use a spray olive oil, if it'll focus. Yeah, there we go. Just use a spray olive oil like this and spray it all over your potatoes because you'll use way less calories doing it that way. And if you guys are wondering, for these potatoes, I put them in the oven for like 20 minutes at 400 degrees. One thing I do like to do though is take my favorite seasoning. You guys will see this a lot throughout the video, and if I don't show it, just know that I'm using this seasoning on a lot of stuff. So I like to add a little bit of this to my rice just to give it, you know, some extra flavor. Just, you know, sprinkle in a little bit of that. All right, we got the chicken cooking up over here, which I just wanted to say, I realized that there's only 5 chicken breasts here, and I kind of want to make sure that I have a good amount of protein, so I'm gonna have one of these with each meal that I make. In my freezer, I also have some pre-cooked shrimp that I've been having recently, so I'm just gonna let this thaw out, and then at the end, I'll make the shrimp last for the other 3 meals that I'm gonna need some protein for. For seasonings on the chicken, I'm gonna do some Himalayan sea salt, black pepper, onion powder, and garlic powder. A nice taste. Make sure that you season this stuff, you guys, because if you don't, it'll be very bland, especially by like the 5th day. So make sure you're adding some good seasonings to it to give it some good flavor. All right, y'all, it's starting to look so pretty. We have a full house going on over here. So the rice is pretty much done and the timer just went off for the potatoes, so I'm gonna check on them and see, you know, if they're close to being done or not. The chicken is looking like it's pretty much done. It looks so good and it smells amazing. And then I started on the veggies. So this is the only pan that I had clean for like sauteing veggies on. So we're gonna do like half the bag at once and then another half of the bag after. But that's fine because I still gotta make the shrimp anyways. Also, low-key, one of the best parts about making meal preps is that you don't have to worry about like all your food being ready at the same time because it's all gonna go in the fridge anyways. Because I'm always just like, oh my god, my rice finished so much earlier, but then I'm like, wait a second, doesn't matter, it's all going in the fridge. So yeah, anyways, we have those veggies sauteing over there, we have the broccoli cooking up right there, and it's looking pretty good. I'm honestly really proud of myself too because like, it doesn't look that clean, but I've been keeping things pretty organized. Ignore these takeout boxes, you guys. This is no longer what we're gonna be eating. I had that the other day and then I just like didn't even wanna put it in the fridge because I knew that I would eat it. So I just let it sit out on my counter and go bad so that way I don't eat it. Yeah, I also just ran some water over the shrimp. So that should be ready to go on the stove once the chicken is done. Oh my gosh, y'all, I'm having a proud ass moment right now. I just feel so accomplished that I like actually made this look really good so far. So I have all the rice all sectioned out. I'm doing carbs first. So the rice is, as you guys can see, all evenly distributed. I don't know why I'm having like a moment right now where I need everything to be perfect looking. I just think that meal prepping is so fun. I don't know why I stopped doing this for so long. As you guys can see, the potatoes are done. They took probably around like in total 35 minutes to do actually. So I'm just gonna section out those into the last 4 containers here and then move on to the next step. Thank you. prep here. Got the last little bit of veggies going and then the shrimp, of course. So this shrimp only takes a couple minutes to actually cook because I bought it pre-cooked. So I just seasoned it and it's almost done and it smells so bomb. Pan desperately needs to be cleaned now after all of this seasoning and cooking. So in the bag for the shrimp that the serving size is like 9 each. So I have to divide this into 3. And I'm just waiting for the last little bit of veggies to be done. But I don't know why, I feel like I cooked maybe a little bit too little veggies on each of these, but you live and you learn. For next time, I'll have more, and if I get hungry with these meal preps, I can always just have a snack. Oh my gosh, I am officially done cooking my meal prep stuff. This honestly, you guys, didn't even take me like an hour and a half tops to do everything. So simple, and now I have 8 meals to be able to eat for the next week or so. So I'll probably last like 5 days with all these, to be honest, because I have a feeling certain days I'm definitely gonna wanna have one of these for lunch as well. But yeah, I think they look so good. I'm definitely gonna take a picture right now because I'm really proud of myself. I just am so excited because this is gonna be so much easier than what I've been doing before, where I would like make a meal like this every single day. Like now I just have everything all set and ready for me, so that way I cannot mess up my healthy eating. I just really haven't been feeling like the most confident recently. Like my skin, like I said, has been suffering and I've just been feeling kind of bloated. I'm literally like getting hot because I've been cooking so much. But yeah, I just haven't been the most confident person in the world, and I'm excited that I just made all of these because I feel like it's gonna get me back on track and back in the right direction for summer. So I'm definitely gonna be doing meal prep videos from now on, and I'll probably do more exciting and different ones than this. I feel like this is like a basic kind of meal prep, but I'll be doing more exciting ones soon. It's just that for my first one back on the grind, I thought I would do, you know, a more traditional meal prep. This pimple is really, really testing me. I'm just gonna end off this video here, even though I look like a little bit of a mess. I'm gonna end it off here so that way this video isn't too long, and I'm gonna start up another one for you guys, like a fitness vlog or like a Sunday vlog. I don't really know what I'm gonna do yet, but I know that I'm gonna film more today, so I'm gonna end off this meal prep video right here. I hope you guys enjoyed my first installment of meal preps. I'm definitely gonna be doing these probably a lot throughout the months because I'm now obsessed with meal prepping again. Like I wanna just do it all the time. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you aren't already. And I love you guys so much, and I'll talk to you in my next video very soon. Bye.